So this lab, we're going to focus on IIS, and it stands for Internet Information Services. Basically, that's Windows Web Server. Previously, we learned about Apache Server and Linux operating system, also Nginx. The Windows form of web server is IIS, that we're going to today learn about that. So to install Lab 1, we go under add role feature. And you know, my IP address has changed here, but you can continue the previous configuration with 192.168.1.1, I assume. And here, when you want to select web server, select this one, web server. And the IIS, Internet Information Service. So the thing is that this one, if you click next and next, there are some rules here. So you see that if you want to have a web developing under IIS, there are some scripting language. If you want to enable FTP, you can enable these two FTP services. So there are some features also like HTTP redirection. There are many things here. Just briefly give you an idea that these are like a feature. If you want to add these features, you can enable these services. But you know that if you add more features, the program that you're running on your server is going to be huge. So that's why here they put it as optional. You select some of the features that you want to enable it. So then next, I just enable FTP from here, and then you install it. So basically, this one is similar to Apache that we installed. After installation, if you open the browser and type HTTP localhost, you should have the first page of your IIS. So I'm just waiting for installation. So I open the browser in the meantime. So I will type here HTTP localhost. All right. So yeah, that's first page. I think something left here, but that's first page of your, yeah, that one also is success. So that's your first page of your Internet Information Service. So also we learn in data communication how to set your self-signed certificate. So here also, if you open the IIS and then go to IIS Manager, then you can go under, if you maximize this one, then you have here server certificate. You see that? So then server certificate, you have here create self-signed certificate. Then it will ask you that you want to set it as a personal. Yes, I want to set it. You put the, like your self-signed cert, for example. Then click OK. And that's your certificate that you have generated here. So if you double click on that certificate, it will show the details. So basically it's based on SHA-256, valid from June 12, 2023 until June 11, 2024. And that's a public key RSA that you have, and you share it with other users. So if you want to bind this certificate, so if you open IIS here, you have the default website and then edit binding. You see that part? Then you can add. So here we want to say port 443, for example. So this one look HTTP. So you change it to HTTPS. And then under SSL certificate, you have your certificate that you generated. So here also there are many options like the protocol of OCSP, which is for validating the certificate. So you have this one, quick protocol, HTTP2 protocol. So if you want to disable any of this protocol, you can disable it from here. Okay, then click OK for this step. So now HTTP and HTTPS, both of them are enabled. So if you restart your web server, basically, you can manage restart your web server from here. And then type here, instead of localhost, type HTTPS localhost. Then look, you have advanced, continue. So that's your HTTPS, but because this certificate is not signed by CAs, that's why your certificate has error. That's like error of not secure, but that's our self-signed certificate that we generated and is part of that. In Linux, we add our name and more options. So here also, that's we are testing based on HTTPS. And that's our self-signed certificate. FTP also, you know that most of these files that you have here, let me show you HTTP. So it's located under inet pop www root. So that's the first page. So if you create a new website, for example, new page here, call it one dot, so if I enable my extension here. So you see the extension of the file. So I change this, rename this file to one dot, for example, HTML. So here, because we are on Windows, I am changing this one with Notepad. So put something, for example, my test. You can also web page. So you can also put here H1 if you want to put it your HTML tag. So it's possible. You can save it and then look the result. If I switch it here and type localhost 1.html, look, it will load that page. So we had that one. So just I want to show you that this part, this inet pop www root, is part of your HTML pass. So also for FTP, by default, it is here. FTP is a file transfer protocol. That's FTP root. If you want to create your own folder, you can create a new folder here, for example, and say, okay, that's my FTP root, like say my FTP directory. Okay, then you can right click on the property, because this one doesn't have permission to write on this file. So you go on the security tab and then under edit. So this is like creator owners. So you should have users. So we edit that users. So here you can add full control for users. See that I add full control. So that means that user now it has read, write, execute permission. And so then when you have done this step, you can go under tools and IIS manager. So the same path. So then you can create your FTP site. So basically you write create and then add FTP site. So that's my FTP site. Where is the physical path? Is located under C, INET pub. So that's my FTP path, right? Next. So here is talking about the binding. Binding means that which IP address is allowed to reach to your FTP server. By default is using port 21. And about here, SSL, that certificate, you can add the certificate, make that one as a SFTP, but if you don't have a certificate, you can select this one, no SSL. So then continue next step. Anonymous, it gives you anonymous to read, write, basic authentication. Basically, you define a user for example, a specific user to add, read, write to your FTP server. So you can add basic and then a specific users that you have here. So I put it as all users, put it as a read, write, execute, execute doesn't have permission here. And you finish it. So that's my FTP server. And then what you do under your firewall, basically by default firewall doesn't allow port 21. So then you go to inbound connection and add your FTP. So you add a new rule here that's predefined. And from this list, you select FTP server, next. And then there are many things that you can enable it. For example, traffic in, traffic SSL. I'm going to enable passive and SSL traffic. So we don't have SSL, but in the future, if you want to enable it, I allow this connection. That means that now FTP is allowed under my server. To test the FTP, you can do it from, for example, these two. Let me see that. This one is under NAT. You can do it from here, I think. Let me do Windows 10 also under NAT. So both of them now, they should receive IP address from DHCP. So this one, yeah, 199.135. So this one also, was it, let me check the IP address quickly. So this one is 199.133. Okay. So in the terminal, let me open new terminal. So CMD, in your terminal, you can do FTP and the IP address of your server 192.168.199.133. That's the IP address of your server. So then probably it allows you to authenticate or not. Let me see that. We have a ping, CMD ping 192.168.199. Actually, I shouldn't have ping because ping is not allowed under my server. Oh, there you go. Connection, connect and then timeout. So let me check again. So then here you can actually, let's see, LS. Right, not connected. So let me exit or quit. Quit. I do it again. Probably something wrong with my configuration, maybe. So I allowed, let me see that. I allow, now it's blocked. I allow everything on my, I don't have a domain controller here. I just have a private and public. So basically when you're doing, you should enable it under your domain because you have domain controller. Let me do FTP. Yeah, that was firewall issue. So now the user. So the users that you have here is coming from Active Directory because mine is work group. So I'm looking at here, but you should look at your Active Directory user group. For example, for my case is administrator. So I put here administrator and the password ABC add 1234. You see that log in. So here, basically you can, for example, let's create a directory, mcod.dir, for example, reports, created, cd reports, command successfully. So look, now if I come back to here, look, I have a report and this directory is created by from Windows 10. So basically, if you do ls, you can do, I allow that one, that's my firewall alerting. So list of directory shows here. And also you can enable that one through the browser. So if you do FTP, 192.168.199.133. We try to pick that application. Probably should be from here. Let me open it from here. FTP 192.168.199.133. Yeah, the same thing. Administrator ABC 1234. Look, that's my folder report, right? So let me raise my files. I'm in Windows 10. So let me, let me copy this file, 17 meg. Copy it in the server, copy it. Now I can verify under report, look, I have this file. So FTP basically is file transfer protocol, but nowadays we are using SSH and SFTP, which is more secure than FTP. And that's it for the FTP and IS lab.